Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another episode of the Juno, where you literally know what you need to know. Alhamdulillah, today I'm very excited to have one of our sheikh here on the show, Sheikh Muhammad bin Uthman. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muhammad al Nasir. Well, I find alhamdulillah, we thank Allah for everything.
It's a pleasure to have you on my show.
I am also having a pleasure meeting you on the show for showing the showable, which is good.
Mashallah.
Barakallahu feekum.
So, guys, before we go into the topic we're going to be discussing today, over the years you've been going to the United States of America to do tafsir every Ramadan. Can you tell us, you know, one of your experiences or maybe an encounter that happened during your visitation to America that you think we really need to know?
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ali sahbi ajma'in. Well, my experience has been very, very exciting,
Inshallah.
Encouraging, and motivating. Because first, when I first reached United States of America, 2014, not for tafsir, just a visit, 2014, when I reached JFK, that is not JFK, JFK airport in New York, I was greeted, I was well received, warmly accepted, respected, even though a Muslim arrived.
From Nigeria.
With my exactly Nigerian, with my flowing gun. I don't change my appearance.
You go with your gun.
Exactly. Okay.
You don't wear suit.
I don't.
Mashallah.
There is no reason for that.
Mashallah.
Though it's not bad. But I prefer maintaining my civilization, call it values.
Mashallah.
It's part of it. I was welcome. Brothers came, they drove from all the boroughs of New York, United, what do you call it, New York City. New York has how many boroughs? Five. Bronx, Manhattan, Staten Island, Brooklyn, and the other one, Queens. A lot of them came to welcome me, so I was highly excited, alhamdulillah.
Mashallah.
My second time was 2015 for tafsir. It happened at Ankasa Masjid. Well received as well. And they told me a lot of people, American, will come and listen to you. And well received. So all 2016, 2017. So my experience, like I told you, was exciting, motivating, and pain, if you like it. So people at times have misconception in America you will have this, but I have never seen anything like maltreatment. Routine exercises of immigration, that's okay.
It went well.
My main purpose was, is, and remains to pass on the message in the better way. Well, we're just managing to make it better, inshallah ta'ala.
Inshallah ta'ala.
According to the Salafi understanding, not extremism and not just leaving things behind, all right? Maintain the middle course in the standard of Islam. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. So this summarizes my experience, and that's your question.
Mashallah.
Barakallahu feekum.
So back to our topic for today, Ya Sheikh. A lot of you go through what we may term that as an existential crisis. You know, what is our purpose in life? We're just here. Most of us feel that we just came here to just play and the likes of it, go to university, and after university, get married. That is it. We're done. What do you think is the reason, and what is our true purpose in life, and how can we achieve this?
That is wrong. Existentialism does not come to Islam or in Islam in a negative manner. Of course, we do exist, but for a purpose. The purpose is aptly captured in Surah 51, verses 56, 7 and 8. Read it. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That captures everything. I have not created the jinn and men but for them to worship me. Who is that me? Allah. So you exist not only to eat and drink and enjoy and whatever, and then you drop dead. No, that is the purpose. Of course, enjoy. Of course, eat well. Wear well. Socialize well. But you should know ultimately you are going to die. You are owned by somebody. You are being owned by him. And you are going to be owned permanently, ceaselessly, perpetually. Even in the grave you are being owned. You didn't come to this life from the blues. Somebody brought you. The way you breathe, oxygen, carbon dioxide is not automatic.
Exactly.
But it's not coincidental. So there must be somebody behind your existence. He told you exist for this purpose, X, Y, Z. In the university, you don't go there to play as you wish. There are rules governing your existence there. All right. In whatever you do in civil service, there are rules. What about Allah? The master of everything. The honor of everything. Doesn't have any purpose for you? He has. So as a Muslim, you have your roadmap. you have your teachings. Those things paint in white our purpose of creation. If you assume you are here just to eat and bring, you're just like an animal. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يَتَمَتَّعُونَ وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَنْعَامُ وَالنَّارُ مَثْوًى لَهُمْ in Surah 46. Those who disbelieve, they just eat and enjoy it the way the animals do.
Yeah.
So a truly believing believer, a practically practicing believer, sees this world as something transitional. More transitional than transition itself. Just a kind of, you want to cut across, go into your own purpose. So don't live as without purpose. You're here to worship Allah. Worship Allah should mark the purpose of your being here. The way you eat, the way you drink, the way you talk, the way you look, the ways.
Yeah.
So only an animal will think he is here just to eat and die.
Hmm.
So the youth you're talking about, they need to be educated. They need to be drawn closer to the scholars that are experienced by means of age, education, qualification, commitment. You need to call them.
Yeah.
Because if you throw them away, you are thrown to the garbage of nihilism and things that are very bad. Have I answered you?
No, Sheikh.
Go on.
So furthermore, you know, how do we align our dunya goals with that of the akhirah so that we can get the best of both worlds?
Wallahi, that is a good blending. I call it blending. That is a mixture of two good things.
Mm.
You see, this life is temporary.
No.
I told you earlier.
Yeah.
I use a different word. It's transitional. More transitional than any transitional progress or program in the whole world. The ulama are saying, "Antum khuliqtum lil akhirah, la lil dunya, wa khuliqat al dunya lakum lil akhirah." This world has been created for you in order to look for the hereafter. Allah says, "Huwa alladhi khalaqa lakum ma fil ardh jami'a." He is Allah who created for you at your own disposal everything on the face of the earth, but for the hereafter. He says, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. This is Quran. Out of what Allah has given you in this world, look for the hereafter. So you can see Quranically, sunnatically speaking, you are not just to live here. You are living for the greater life. So you can have the blending that can only be achieved if you are educated. You are Quranically sound, sunnatically engineered. You have the capacity, the ability to understand.
Yeah.
Then you put your legs on where Allah wants you to put. That's how you blend. Don't consume alcohol because you're in the world. Don't commit zina because you are spoiling hereafter. Don't be a backbiter. Don't be a liar, a rumor monger, a character assassinator,
yeah,
a thief. Through pen robbery in politics and whatever. Through examination malpractices, you know, and a lot of things to be said. Through yellow journalism, what you call it, irresponsible journalistic irresponsibility.
No.
You should have what we call repertorial, what cultural practices, which is good. These things capture the essence of existence. So through these and many other things, you can blend the two. But if you feel I am just here, like the kafirun are saying, well, we are here, we just live and eat and finish, that's all. A Muslim is not like this. He looks for the hereafter. So that's how you blend the two.
We've got to combine
the really eat what is good, live what is bad, talk well, speak well, look well in this world.
Sure.
And don't forget, Allah says, as another case of blending, He says, "Qul man harrama zinatallahi allati akhraja li ibadihi wa tayyibati min ar-rizq." In chapter number 7. Tell them who denies the usage of the goodies of life. Use them, but for good purpose. So own money. Don't allow money to own you. Have power. Don't allow power to have you. Have influence. Don't be influenced by negative power. In so doing, you will be able to combine the combinable.
You've got to be balanced in everything.
Really, really, really. In eating habit, don't eat excessively. Don't sleep excessively. Don't. There are a lot of don'ts. Because you have a mission, you have a goal, and you should know. Each and every Muslim has 5 days.
Yeah.
5 days. Yawmun, what do you call it? Mafqood. Wa yawmun mashhud, wa yawmun mawrud, wa yawmun mamdud, wa yawmun maw'ud. 5 days. The lost days, that's day number one. The present time or day. The upcoming day. The promised day and the extended days. These are the 5 days. So a true believer should know this critically, analytically, so that he knows how to put everything in the proper shape and perspective.
Mashallah.
By so doing, you will definitely be happy at the time you are taking your exit out of this life.
May Allah grant us a successful
life. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen.
Barakallahu Sheikh.
Wafikum
barak. There is a common misconception that if Allah Jalla Jalalu Malik, you know, knows, he has predestined everything for
yep.
us, like he knows whatever that will happen to us, then whatever we do, is it that we are, you know, we are being forced, or why will Allah, you know, hold us
responsible for our misdeeds
and the likes?
Right. May I ask you again, why wouldn't you go and just spread your mattress on a highway and just sleep? Because if Allah did not decree you are going to be die, you'll not die. Try it. Try it. They say, okay, I'm going to do it. This is not good. I know some people ask the person this question.
Yeah, yeah.
But did Allah tell you are the one to go to the hellfire? Did he? He gave you chances of walking. Allah says, walk, you will see. Allah will see. So Allah is telling you, I have the power to destine what is good and bad. When he created you as a human, he gave you faculty of thinking. Don't drink. You have every opportunity not to drink. And you drank. And you're saying, why Allah shot this? Did he tell you to drink? Can you go and slap the governor on your stand and say, oh, your excellency, Allah decreed that?
Do arrested.
It. Don't do it. A university student, can you tell me that, well, I don't have to cut the exam. My professor knows I want to pass my exam. But let me be sleeping. Because Allah has this team. If I'll succeed, I will. Try. Try. You will come out of your first class. Yeah. Or first class failure. Of course.
Absolutely.
So that is called Al-Qada'ul Kawni and Al-Qada'ul Shari. People don't understand this concept. There are two kinds of predestination. Al-Qada'ul Kawni and Al-Qada'ul Shari. People asking this don't even know this classification. Al-Qada'ul Kawni is predetermination by means of human nature. Take for example, Allah has decreed that a cobra that is poisonous is dangerous. But a ram is important because I can slaughter it. Why don't you tell me, well, Allah created the cobra and the ram, I will put together in my room and sleep. That's okay. Try. You won't do that. Commonsensically, you will not allow cobra in your room. You'll do everything possible to even kill it, to get rid of it.
Absolutely.
But in terms of ram, you have it. Why don't you? Because they're all created by Allah. That is Al-Qada'ul Kawni. But Al-Qada'ul Shari'i said, don't do that. وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّحَلُكَ. If you bring cobra, it bites you and you die, you are to blame.
Absolutely.
But by the time you have your ram, it's usual. That is the example. That is why Satan in Surah Ibrahim chapter number 14 will be saying to those in the hellfire, وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعُوتُكُمْ فَسَجَبْتُمْ لِي. Satan, did you see me in the world? Did you see me? I just whispered into your heart and you hearkened to me. Blame yourself. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. So that kind of question shouldn't be asked. If it is asked, this is part of the answer to be given. There is Al-Qada'ul Qawni and Al-Shari'i. You in your life schemes, you will not do that.
Exactly.
If you maintain prayers 5 times a day, does somebody stop you?
No.
If I want to read Quran today, can somebody stop you?
Not at all.
Is Allah telling you if Allah will deny you the reward? Not Why don't all. You do it? If somebody takes arm and kills somebody, did Allah send to kill?
No.
You're going to be responsible.
Exactly.
Are you telling me, okay, they are telling you there is no excuse, ignorance of law. They say what? It's not an excuse.
Yeah.
In Nigerian system, if a policeman tells you where, okay, traffic warden tells you, you are caught for not wearing your belt. You'll tell him, well, you know, I'm a Nigerian. I love Nigeria. They say, yeah, that love apart, but law. You break it.
The law.
You're responsible.
Obviously.
Why don't you that very question in this very case? You are using this concerning your akhirah. You should be very careful. Allah is not zalim. Allah does not inflict wrongdoing on anybody. Yeah. Allah does not do that. Yeah. But what they say is there is al-qada'ul kawni and al-shari'i. Don't mix the two. Go to school.
Yeah. Allahu Allah. Wa iyyakum. Just before we end the program, Sheikh, what message do you have for those young Muslim youth out there who are trying to become better in the deen?
Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, we have a lot of them. You see, the Quran says, "Innahum fityatun amanu bi rabbihim zidna mahuda." Wallahi, my message to our young ones coming up is that they should fear Allah. But for you to fear Allah, you have to be perpetual knowledge seeker. Perpetual beneficial knowledge seeker. Seek for knowledge. And they're good scholars, scholarly scholars, scholastic scholars, who can differentiate between the chaps and what have you. They should also be careful of disobeying Allah. They shouldn't go near zina. They should avoid substance abuse, drug abuse. My khutbah in Kano last week talked about 9 signs of drug addiction. And a lot of you said, wow, it is as if Sheikh was there. He was talking, he was touching our mind. I said, no, Allah touched you, not me. Allah using me as an instrument, okay. This is my message. They should not participate in political rascalism, political hooliganism, political brigandage, political prostitution, where some people use them to achieve their end. This summarizes my message. May Allah bless them. May Allah give them the power, the ability, the capacity to carry the message to high parts. May Allah accept all of our deeds.
I mean, Jazakallah khair.
Wa iyyakum hafizakumullah.
Beautiful having you.
Barakallah fiikum.
Jazakallah khair. I hope to have you someday again.
Barakallah fiikum. MashaAllah. Barakallah fiikum.
So, dear viewers, alhamdulillah, we've come to the end of today's episode. You've known what you need to know. We ask Allah to make it easy for us. Until we meet again, I'll leave you all in the care of Allah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.